The plea was made by Fred Opolot, the Pingire County Member of Parliament, who also doubles as Vice Chairperson of Foreign Affairs Committee, while appearing before Parliament's Budget Committee to present a report of the National Budget Framework paper on the sector.
The annual budget line totaling 4 billion, 4 billion for NAM and 2 billion to cater for the G77 for the post-summit activities for the next 3 years. And 1 year concurrently should be provided to the Minister of Foreign Affairs.
Opolot informed the Budget Committee that despite the ongoing summit in Munyonyo, Uganda will be chairing and coordinating the non-aligned movement post-summit activities for the next 3 years, and there is need to avail 4 billion shillings in the 2024-2025 budget to oversee these activities.
So we are looking, let us not just stop looking at this summit that's going on right now, but there are going to be activities going on for the next 3 years. And Foreign Affairs is supposed to play a coordination role. So we shall need money in our missions, for example, in Addis, in Nairobi, in New York, to ensure that all these programs and activities run throughout the 3 years.
Opolot defended the budget request, arguing that the secretariats in charge of the NAM will be charged with undertaking research, preparations of position papers, hosting or participation in meetings and mini-summits, support missions with NAM chapters, plus sending and receiving envoys.
Missions predominantly with international organizations such as New York and Addis. Will be hosting, participating in meetings at diplomatic and technical levels, preparing documents in line with the outcome documents of this summit, traveling inland and abroad to participate in extraordinary sessions of the Council of Foreign Ministers, participate in international conferences on environment, human rights.
But members of Parliament wondered why Parliament should be bothered by such a request if the Ministry of Foreign Affairs did not bother to allocate funds for post-NAM summit activities.
You are labouring to explain the importance of NAM, G77. It is already here. The Ministry knows. How can then the Minister not have money allocated to support this? Did you interact with them?
When did the ministry know that there will be requirement for post-NAM activities?
But as I said again, unfortunately, our engagement with the ministry on that issue critically just happened about a month or so ago.
Uganda took over leadership of NAM from Azerbaijan yesterday and appointed Ambassador Adonia Ayebare as the coordinator of NAM activities. Uganda's NAM secretariat will be hosted in New York, USA. Lawmakers also asked the ministry to explain in detail the series of activities to be undertaken by Uganda in its NAM leadership.
Not because we don't want to support, but we just want to know what exactly is the 4 billion going to do in the next 3 years, and where is it going to be allocated, given that now you're still hanging?
When you talk about NAM, G7 plus China, it's about the foreign relations with the rest of the world. We're talking about memorandum of organization, bilateral engagements. We're talking about joint permanent commission. We're talking about business engagements. So these require the foreign relations sector, where Foreign Affairs falls on its mission, to be able to coordinate these other activities at the end of the day.
Meanwhile, lawmakers also raised concerns over the failure by the government to allocate 41.8 billion shillings for annual subscription to international organizations after realizing that no single penny was availed to clear the 41.8 billion shillings pending arrears to these international organizations.
Budget framework purpose is to link the government policies to the budget. But not for you under Foreign Affairs. Outrightly, your policies are not linked to the budget. Because from what you presented, nothing on foreign policy is prioritized.
The organizations under question include United Nations, World Food Programme, African Union, among others. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.